Hey there, welcome to Into the Fire. I'm Rob Reed, president of Bison Fire Protection. Every week, we're going into the fire to pull out life lessons learned from frontline professionals and apply them to fire protection, fire safety, and most importantly, everyday life. This week, we're going into the fire to talk about the simple things in life and how often those simple things are by far the most important to us. Life can be complicated if we make it that way. Now, I want to take a minute and kind of talk about the Beatles, because I'm a big Beatles fan. Anyone that knows me knows that. But there was nothing simple about the Beatles' music. If you're a musician, you'll know what I'm talking about, the syncopations, the different chord changes that they did in their music. But later on in life, John Lennon was really trying to simplify his life. His second son was born, and he was really trying to move himself away from being that celebrity to being a true stay-at-home dad and raise his son properly. If you can imagine the problems that John Lennon must have faced, having to have his doorman send Mick Jagger away because he didn't want to hang out with him. But at least now we know where Mick's famous pout came from. But one of the things I want to talk about with John was one of his songs to his son Sean. He talked about life is what happens to you when you're busy making other plans. And it's just so true. Sometimes we're so caught up in what we're doing and trying to plan for every minute, we forget about the simple things. We forget about to take that minute and smell the flowers. Now, let's talk about the simple things that may save your life one day. You know, diet, exercise, and I'm telling you, I'm working on both. I'm trying to diet a little bit more, and I'm getting on my bicycle every morning at 6 a.m. and going for a rip around the neighborhood. Although sometimes I don't know if that's extending my life based on the semis and crazy truck drivers that are trying to get their way to work every day. But let's also talk about regular visits to the doctor. How often, and okay, let's talk, guys. Those of us that are over 50, how many times were we going to see the doctor for the big visit? You know the one I'm talking about. And how about the time we need to spend on mental health? And I'm going to tell you, that is a big topic these days, and it's not just a little bit about where we're going with things. Mental health is one of those issues that hits more and more people for more and more reasons. Now, I want to talk also a little bit about reminding your family of how important they are to you. And I know that's something, again, myself, I'm working on. I know that my family is important to me, but do I tell them often enough? And I think about some of the important times that I've had going back quite a number of years ago, sitting on a nice, comfortable deck, having a drink with my wife, looking over a lake, and watching one of the most incredible meteor showers. I found out later on in life that that meteor shower comes by every 100 years or so. For us to have been on that deck at that time with a clear sky, it really was a simple moment, but it was one of those moments that we will remember forever. I'm going to tell you, the true joy in life is found in the everyday. Those moments spent when you're laughing with your kids, laughing with your friends, riffing off of each other, and just having a good time. Really, how much more simple can it be? And how much more important can it be? How often when you're sitting with your friends are you sitting there laughing about that big job that you just completed at work? Or are you really laughing about something funny you've done together? Reminiscing about some of those important times, those fun things that we've done. And trust me, I can tell stories about my friends and I can imagine there's 5 guys out there right now cringing, hoping to God that I don't go there. Maybe I will in one of these episodes. For now, guys, you're kind of off the hook. But let's really talk about the simple things. Now, I've got a good friend, Wallace Drysdale, who's with the Stony Mountain Fire Department. He's also a captain with the City of Winnipeg Fire Department. And he has an incredible story to share with us about the simple things in life and how important they are. Let's take a minute and listen to what Wallace has to say about the simple things.
My name's Wallace Drysdale. I'm a professional firefighter with the City of Winnipeg with 27 years experience. And currently at the rank of captain. I'm also Stony Mountain Rockwood Fire Department fire chief here. A couple years ago, on a cold January 1st night, about 11:30 at night, 911 dispatched us to a working structural fire with people trapped. They had multiple calls. Whenever you get a call like that that says multiple calls, you know it's a working fire. We sent the crews down. Now, incidentally, I used to live two houses down, so I knew the people were there. I knew there was two elderly people in their 80s in the house. One had dementia, and there was mobility issues. We arrived on scene, and the neighbors were there, and they had indicated to us that one of the members, the people had gotten out, the man with dementia, and when they looked out the window, he was removing the cars from the garage. I noticed when I got on scene, the side door was open, and the fire was quite visible, shooting out the back window and the front door. We dispatched teams on a fire attack and rescue simultaneously. The guys knocked down the fire right away, and we searched the house, and they found the lady in the bedroom, pulled her out. She initially had a heart beat, and at the same time as they pulled her out, Star's helicopter had landed in the schoolyard next to him, and she passed away seconds later. In the investigation after the fire, we did notice that there was no working smoke alarms in the entire structure. The front door had been left open, which feeds the fire as the air comes in. And the fire had started from a space heater in the bedroom of the man with dementia. So whether it was a malfunctioning heater or it was placed too close, it was impossible to tell because it was melted. It had even melted a hole through the floor where the heater was. So that's how much fire and smoke and stuff was there. So when we examined the bedroom where the lady was, we noticed that the door had fire marks on it, like it had been closed, which is what you want. You want when you go to sleep at night to shut your bedroom door. She had done that, but because there is no working smoke detectors or alarms, she was alerted late. She appears to have ran to the door, opened the door, took a deep breath of that smoke and heat, backed up, and tried to go out the window, and a few seconds later, it was it. So the lesson to be learned, if you do sleep in your bedroom with the doors closed, it's nice to have a working smoke alarm so it alarms you. And if there is a fire, open the door, feel the door for heat, look for a smoke. If it's black smoke, do not exit there. You will not make it. Black smoke kills you in about two breaths.
So thanks, Walls, for all that great information in that story. The things we need to work towards are keeping our doors closed. Maybe it takes you a few minutes or a few days to get used to doing that. But once we start doing it, making those habits, we make our world a whole lot safer. I mean, I can dive into things like once your door is closed and you think you have a fire, touch the door to make sure it's not hot before you open it. But let's remember that the first step really in keeping it simple is just close that bedroom door. Get the kids used to doing that. If they need a nightlight, let them have a nightlight. It's 7 watts. It's nothing on the hydro bill. Give them some comfort. Give yourself some comfort by keeping it safe and keeping it simple. And the bigger takeaway here is always take time for the simple things in life. Make sure you're enjoying that time with your family. As we wrap things up here, I know you learned something today at Into the Fire. If you have a moment, share it with your friends and family. You can make your world a safer place. I'm Rob Reed. This is Into the Fire. Have yourself a fantastic day.